Hey, welcome to the Coupler.io Academy, where industry experts share tips and tricks on working with data. In this video, we will learn how to create a dashboard in Google Sheets. Not only that, we'll also see how to add a layer of interactivity by using filters. And I'll also share a secret technique to keep our data fresh automatically. If you want to follow along as I prepare a Google Sheets dashboard, the link to the spreadsheet I'm using will pop up in the corner of your screen. And you can also find it in the video description below. I'm looking at a sheet containing information from multiple flower shops across the United States. But in this current format, the data is really hard to consume. This is where a Google Sheets dashboard comes in handy. Let's start off by creating a new sheet called Dashboard. In this new sheet, I'll add our first chart. And to do so, I'll go to the Insert menu and select Chart. In the Chart Editor, I'll choose the chart type. And for the first one, let's go with a scorecard. Next up, you'll want to provide some data for our dashboard in Google Sheets. To do so, click the Data Range button, which will allow you to navigate through the file and select the data. For this example, let's select all the online sales, starting with the first row all the way to the bottom. I'll want to aggregate the total sales number and use the sum operator to do so. Since I'm looking at a big number, let's shorten it a bit. So go to the Customize tab and under the key value, select the scale factor of 1 million. You can also add a custom number format and add an M as a suffix. And just like that, you've built your first Google Sheets dashboard. Now, to add a little context to the report, let's go back to the Customize tab, and under Chart and Axis Titles, I'll add Total Sales as the title. Let's resize it and move it to the top of the page. Next up is a line chart. I want to display the total sales of our flower shops each month. To make it easier, I'll jump back to my online sales sheet and add a new column called Month. I will then use an array formula with the text function inside that will take the month out of our order date in the second column. As a range, let's specify B2 to B4977 and filter by month using MMM. Close the parentheses and you should be good to go. Let's switch back to our dashboard sheet. And now I get to finally add the new chart to my Google Sheets dashboard. Just like before, I select the chart from the Insert menu, and this time I'll select the line chart in the editor. I'll select the two inputs for our axis. In my case, it will be month and order total. For the axis, you'll select month and also tick the aggregate button. Under series, select order total. I'll resize and move it, so I can create another chart. For this third one, let's use a table chart. Click the Insert button and select Chart. From the editor, you want to select the table chart. Now in the Data Range field, select your sheet and then the product category and order total columns. I'll aggregate the results, resize, and move them next to the line chart. Now it's starting to look like a proper dashboard already. But now, onto the cool part. Let's make our dashboard in Google Sheets interactive by adding a slicer filter. Go to Data and select Add a Slicer, and in the Data range, select the entire file by going from A1 to N4977. From the Data tab on the right, you can choose to filter by anything you want. In my case, I'll pick order type so I can see the sales numbers for retail orders or wholesale. And there you have it, a fully interactive Google Sheets dashboard. And before I wrap up, I've mentioned a little secret that I was going to tell you. This Google Sheets dashboard example is based on static data that's been added to the file manually. In some cases, that's fine, but more often than not, you'll want to see an up-to-date version of your data. So you are left with two options. You either keep adding new records every time a sale happens, or you can use Coupler.io, which will automatically import the data for you on a predefined schedule, keeping your dashboard up to date. Sign up for a Coupler.io account and start a free 14-day trial. No credit card is needed. Use it to import your data from dozens of available integrations. Transform it on the spot and build a fully automated Google Sheets dashboard. And that's it. Now you know how to create a dashboard in Google Sheets. But if you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a like, share the video with others, and subscribe to our channel so you never miss a thing. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one.